Alright, so first of all, we're going to go ahead and add the background colors. I'm going to add some red. And it doesn't have to be very thick, guys. It's just thin layers, very light layers. Some red, a little bit of blue. Again, see how I'm not really making any thick patches. Just really thin. Alright. Now, I'm going to tear off a piece of magazine. Like so, and on it I'm gonna spray some white. Now this can be very thick. Now you don't have to use a piece of magazine, it can be anything else, but I use magazine just so I can show you guys. Alright, so this is gonna create our iceberg. So I used the white and the blue, and the blue was, I used it on the last because I want the white parts to be on the bottom, and you'll see the effect that will create. See that? Let's take a closer look at that. See how you see the blue on top? Well, that's why I chose those colors, and I chose them in that order. I want the dominant color to be blue, and the highlights, well, they will be white. Alright, this bottom part that I'm using here in the bottom, that I'm creating, this is going to be the reflection on the water. Or it could either be a reflection or it could be the actual iceberg underneath. Now this part doesn't have to be too detailed, because we're going to put some blue on top of it, symbolize water. Just like so. So you don't have to spend a lot of time making it real detailed. Yeah, that'll work. Okay, now with a little bit of blue, see, I'm just going to darken it a little bit. Using a straight edge, I'm going to create the water line. See that? There's the blue, there's the sky. Alright, now, this is the same technique that we use to create comets. Now, wait a little bit until the water line is nice and dry. Just like so, and just make it random. You know, you don't want to keep them uniform. Remember that when light hits the water, it creates different shapes, different effects. So make it random. Now, once you're done doing that, I'm gonna add some white, a thick layer of white, and blue on top of that. That's what we're gonna use to create the water. Okay, now with a magazine sheet, fold it and just very gently start mixing the colors back and forth. And that's all it takes, folks, just back and forth, just like so. And you can get more complex, you know, in different icebergs, but this is just the basics on how to create one. You guys experiment. If you guys have any questions or comments, please feel free to send me a message. Alright, now here in the distance, I'm just going to create a light source. You guys remember how to do that? We use this for stars as well. I think I'll leave it like that. Alright. Okay. Now, where all those points connect, I'm just going to go ahead and spray a... just one quick burst in there, and there you go, folks. That's what you get. Alright. Well, I hope you guys have enjoyed. Until next time, thank you for watching. Here's just some samples of some previous icebergs that I managed to scan in. This is similar to the one that we just painted. See, you guys know how to create this now. Possibilities are endless. Once again, thank you guys.